إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أخرج الإمام أحمد في مسنده وابن حبان في صحيحه والحاكم في المستدرك وأيضا الإمام النسائي في السنن الكبرى من حديث طلحة ابن عبيد الله وعمر بن الخطاب وأيضا جابر ابن عبد الله رضي الله عن الجميع. An authentic chain of narration, an event or an incident or a conversation which took place between Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه and Talha ibn Ubaydillah رضي الله عنه after the death of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Umar observed that Talha is a little bit distressed. فقال له, he said to him, ما بك يا أبا محمد? What is wrong with you, Abu Muhammad? Are you upset because of so and so? He mentioned the reason. Talha رضي الله عنه قال لا والله. By Allah, this is not the reason. ولكني سمعت كلمة من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم making a statement, and I did not inquire about it. And then he said, I heard the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ كَلِمَةً لَا يَقُولُهَا عَبْدٌ عِنْدَ مَوْتِهِ إِلَّا وَأَشْرَقَ لَهَا لَوْنُهُ وَنَفَّسَ اللَّهُ كُرْبَتَهُ وَوَجَدَتْ رُوحُهُ لَهَا رَوْحًا حين تخرج من جسده وكانت له نورا في صحيفته يوم القيامة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, I know a statement that a servant of Allah would say it at the time of his death, except the four following things will happen. His complexion, his face will shine after his death. his distress, the distress of death, kurbatul maut, will be eased on him, and his soul will find security as it departs and as it leaves his body, and it will be a light, it will be recorded in his book in the day of resurrection. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say what word. And we know that the Sahaba were not supposed to ask at one stage questions. That is why Talha did not ask. Fatalha radiallahu an was distressed because he did not know what a person can say at the bed of death in order to receive these four glad tidings. فقال له عمر عمر رضي الله عنه said to him, والله إني لا أعلم أي كلمة أرادها رسول الله. By Allah, I know the kalima, the statement which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam meant. Talha said to Umar, وَمَا هِيَ, what word? Umar said, وَأَيُّ كَلِمَةٌ أَعْظَمْ مِنَ الْكَلِمَةِ الَّتِي أَرَادَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَمَّهُ أَنْ يَنْطِقَ بِهَا عِنْدَ مَوْتِهِ. What other statement greater than the statement which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted his uncle Abu Talib to utter it at the bed of death? Innaha la ilaha illallah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, كما في حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما في الصحيحين, that when we experience distress in this world, if we utter لا إله إلا الله, it will ease that distress. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم دعاء الكرب, the supplication which a Muslim should make when he is distressed, لا إله إلا الله العظيم الحليم, لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم, لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش الكريم. And death is also a distress. Death is one of the heaviest, most difficult time on a human being. The extraction of the soul out of the body is difficult. Hatta even ala Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha radiallahu anha, كما في البخاري narrates, والله, by Allah, ما رأيت أحدا أشد عليه كربة الموت من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I have not seen someone experiencing the heaviness and the distress and the agonies of death more than the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she narrates, next to him he had a bucket of water, and he used to dip his hand, and he used to wipe his face, and he used to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, la ilaha illallah, أَلَا إِنَّ لِلْمَوْتِ لَسَكَرَاتِ. He used to utter, لا إله إلا الله, Indeed, death has agonies. Brothers and sisters in Islam, death is one of the moments where you need to say La ilaha illallah. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to those who are observing a person who is passing away, to prompt him, to ask him to say La ilaha illallah. And he mentioned the wisdom why it will help his soul to leave his body. Hadith ibn Mas'ud fi Mustadrak al-Hakim qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لقنوا موتاكم لا إله إلا الله فإن روح المؤمن تخرج رشحا. If you prompt your deceased to say لا إله إلا الله, and if they say it, it will help their souls to leave their bodies like a sweat. The question here, brothers and sisters in Islam, is it easy to say at the bed of death? Is it easy to say like you say it now? No, it is not. Wallahi, it is not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can turn your tongue like a huge mountain that you cannot move. وَلَا يَقُولُهَا إِلَّا مَنْ عَلِمَهَا وَأَيْقَنَ بِهَا وَقَبِلَهَا وَانْقَادَ إِلَيْهَا بِإِخْلَاصٍ وَصِدْقٍ وَمَحَبَّةٍ. And the one who will be able to say it is the one who learned it, was certain about it, accepted it, adhered to it, complied to it with sincerity, truthfulness, and love. A lot of us, they say, just say La ilaha illallah at the bed of death, you're good to go. Another statement that we hear all the time, just say La ilaha illallah, you will enter Jannah. Yani, al hadith sahih. The hadith is authentic. Man qala La ilaha illallah, دخل الجنة. That is correct. If you say La ilaha illallah, you will enter Jannah. But I want to share with you, in the time I have, the statement of one of the scholars of this ummah regarding this statement, regarding this hadith in particular. A scholar who used to be from the people of the book and he accepted Islam, his name is Wahb ibn Munabbih rahimahullah. Yuqal annahu min al-jil al-thalith fi kalam fi al-siyar a'lam al-nubala an tarikhihi. It was mentioned that he belongs to the third generation, rahimahullah. He was asked, didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whosoever says La ilaha illallah will enter Jannah? He said, correct. This is correct. The key to Jannah is La ilaha illallah. Without that key, no Jannah. Wallahi, even if your son is Ibrahim alayhi salam, وَتَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ Ibrahim, and you know who Ibrahim is عليه الصلاة والسلام. قال تعالى واتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took Ibrahim for a friend. On the day of resurrection, Ibrahim, كما أخرج الشيخان من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, Ibrahim عليه السلام will intercede for his father who rejected لا إله إلا الله. He will say to Allah, أَلَمْ تَعِدْنِي أَلَّا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Haven't you promised me, O Allah, not to disgrace me today? وَأَيُّ خِزْي مِنْ أَبِي الْأَبْعَدِ. What other disgrace that my father will be dragged to hell? يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. O Ibrahim, إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الْجَنَّةَ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Jannah is haram for someone who rejected لا إله إلا الله. Find now Muslims saying Christians and Jews and others who receive the message of La ilaha illallah, they get to go to Jannah. ماشي بيع يا سيدي الجنة انت على مزاجك. You sell the Jannah, go ahead and sell them Jannah. Make them happy, go ahead, make them happy. Make them happy, make them happy. Earn their acceptance يا سيدي. شكر. تمام عندك دين اهو. عندك قرآن وسنة. You find Muslims saying that. فيس, the key to Jannah is La ilaha illallah. But listen, every key must have teeth to open. Ridges. If you have a key without teeth, I'm still addressing, talking about the statement of the scholar Wahb ibn Munabbih. He says, لِكُلِّ مُفْتَاحٍ أَسْنَانٍ. If you have a key that, which does not have teeth, it will not open. You do like this, it will not open. وأسنان لا إله إلا الله هي شروطها. And the teeth to لا إله إلا الله, the conditions for لا إله إلا الله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the first of these conditions, العلم. You must learn it. You don't just say لا إله إلا الله like this without knowing what لا إله إلا الله is. دليلها فاعلم. سورة محمد, فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. Learn لا إله إلا الله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says كما عند مسلم, من قال لا إله إلا الله عالما بها. Whosoever says لا إله إلا الله knowing it will enter Jannah. وقوله تعالى, إلا من شهد بالحق وهم يعلمون. ولا تنفع الشفاعة عنده إلا لمن شهد بالحق وهم يعلمون. Those who bear witness to لا إله إلا الله, الحق, while they know it. Know what يا إخوة, know what, know the meaning of لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله means لا معبود بحق إلا الله. No one deserves submission, worship, obedience but Allah. ولذلك تجد الكلمة, you will find الكلمة is made of two components, نفي عام وإثبات تام. نفي وإثبات, negation, affirmation. Oh. Negation, affirmation. Look, لا إله, you must first disbelieve that there is other gods. Disbelieve in the fact that there are other gods who deserve to be worshipped beside Allah first. You must dismiss that. You must negate that. تنفي هذا. And then affirm Allah to be the worship, the obeyed. That is why a Muslim who says Allah is a God, Jesus is God, Buddha is God, the sun is God, the moon is God, let's make everybody happy, Salamu alaykum. Tell him that. Ma nafait. You have not negated. You have not dismissed any other God. You must. Shuf. فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. You must disbelieve first in something called the طاغوت. وكما قال ابن القيم, الطاغوت هو كل ما يعبد من دون الله. الطاغوت is anything that can be worshipped or is worshipped beside Allah. You must disbelieve in that. Oh. نفي, affirm, إثبات. You must also learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, the sustainer, the provider. You must also believe in His Lordship. You must also believe in His names and attributes. The way, that our righteous predecessors understood it and believed in it. And you must single him out with your action. So teeth number one, condition number one, knowledge of that. And this is the hardest. You need to embark on this, brothers, sisters in Islam. Learn your aqidah. Learn your deen. Your deen begins from here, with the knowledge of that. Probably heard me in my previous khutbah last Friday, especially here in America, in the West. We're supposed to convey La ilaha illallah to the Christian and the Jews. We must learn it. يا معاذ أو معاذ إنك تأتي قوما أهل كتاب ليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه لا إله إلا الله. You're going to Yemen, يا معاذ. The people there are Christian and Jews. Let be the first thing you talk to them about is لا إله إلا الله. Learning لا إله إلا الله توحيد. Two, that knowledge, brothers and sisters in Islam, must lead to certainty, to al-yaqeen. Al-yaqeen. You must be certain that Allah exists. ولذلك, there a Muslim comes and says, في إله ولا في قد ولا ما فيش. والله يعني in the Quran it says there is, بس مش عارف. يعني I'm not. سلام عليكم. Tell him, salamu alaykum, da'ahu, la ilaha illa, saqatat hadhi, saqat. I'm certain Allah exists. I'm certain He's the creator, the sustainer, the provider. I'm certain He has the most beautiful names, the most perfect attributes. I'm certain He is the only one who deserves worship and obedience and submission. No doubt. قال تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى says إنما المؤمنون اسمعوا إنما المؤمنون indeed the believers الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا those who believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى and His messenger and they never doubt it never doubt it never doubt it Important. Important. وَمَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مُسْتَيْقِنًا بِهَا قَلْبُهُ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ Whosoever لا إله إلا الله, whoever says لا إله إلا الله and his heart is certain of it will enter Jannah. Oh. اليقين. Two. Three. Acceptance. القبول. You see, subhanallah, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew. Abu Talib knew that la ilaha illallah is true. And you know what? He was certain about it. But he never accepted it. Never. Why? Ancestors. Kibr. ولذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى says إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون وسبحان الله in America in particular how many people you meet in America how many people you meet them Christians and Jews and atheists sometimes يعني atheist يعني modern atheist you tell him you believe there is a God yeah I believe there is a God طيب, you believe that he made all of this? يقول لك, ah, I believe it's one or three or four or how many gods? Well, no, one God. There is one God only. Oh, يعني he believed he, you're sure about that? يقول لك, I'm sure. طب ما تيجي الجامع معايا, come to the masjid with me and say, لا إله إلا الله. يقول لك, لا 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 لا, it's in the heart, in the heart. سلام عليكم. لا, you must accept it, يا حبيبي. You must accept it and say it. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Jews and the Christians, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَإِنَّ فَرِيقًا مِّنْهُمْ لَيَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ they know about Muhammad and the truth that he brought more than, they are more certain about Muhammad than their children. What is meant is, yani, they are more certain that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah than being certain whether that child is my son or not. You go ask the mother, Allah al-musta'an. وَمَعْرِفَتُهُمْ لِمُحَمَّدْ أَشَدْ. But they rejected it. مَا قَبِلَهَا. هو ليه أبو جهل وأبو جهل. أبو جهل believed that Allah is the creator, the sustainer, the provider. عتبة ولئن سألتهم من خلق السماوات والأرض ليقولن الله ولئن سألتهم من خلقهم ليقولن الله. عتبة وشيبة. The disbelievers in Mecca, they knew, they were certain the creator is Allah. الرب هو الله. The sustainer is Allah. طيب قل لا إله إلا الله. لا ما قولهاش. I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to accept it. علم, knowledge leads to certainty, يقين. Three, acceptance. Now number four, and this is where I would say 75% of the Muslims are in the other end of things. Compliance. Compliance. Inqiyad. Salli, pray five times. La ba. Fikri al-irja. There is a sect, ya ikhwa, in the ummah called al-murji'ah. Naful amal min al-iman. عرفوا الإيمان كده على مزاجهم. قالوا الإيمان اللي انت تقول يا عم لا إله التصديق وخلاص, وتقول لا إله إلا الله كلمة كده عشان انت تتجوز مسلمة ويحفظ دمك وخلاص والموضوع خلص. فكر. يقول لك ايه, what is إيمان? They ask المرجئة, what is إيمان? A lot of Muslims belong to that sect unknowingly. He doesn't know, by the way, that he belongs to that sect. He doesn't know, but he does their acts. What does he say? All what you have to do, صدق بقلبك, believe in your heart. No, be certain, say it with your tongue so you can marry a Muslim woman, you can receive some zakah, you can be in the community in the day of Eid, وخلاص الموضوع خلص. Oh, طب الصلاة ومش, لا ده بمزاجي بقى. يقول لك ده when I feel like. لا يا حبيبي. ومن يسلم وجهه لله وهو محسن فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى, والعروة الوثقى هي لا إله إلا الله. You must comply to لا إله إلا الله. Pray five times. سمعنا وأطعنا. I hear and obey. Fast. I hear and obey. Wear your hijab. I hear and I obey. Do not steal. I hear and I obey. Do not backbite. I hear and I obey. Do not gossip. I hear and I obey. Do not deal in usury, I hear and obey. Do not commit adultery, I hear and I obey. Do not lie, I hear and I obey. Do not cheat, I hear and I obey. ما هو بحلى. Where the ummah is lacking? للقياد. ما هي, شوف, لا إله إلا الله doesn't mean لا خالق إلا الله. A lot of Muslims, they think that لا إله إلا الله is you believe that Allah is the creator, Allah is the sustainer, Allah is the provider, Allah is all of this. La la la. Guess what? Satan did that. Satan did this. Wallahi, Satan did it better than Muslims. What was the problem of Satan? Why is he going to be a dweller of the hellfire for eternity? What was his issue? Bow down. He said no. زي المسلم الآن صلي. لا ما معلش. يعني مش عايزين نكفر الناس. بعضهم يفعل هذا كسلا يعني. غير مستحيل. Or is not denying the command. طيب Satan said, why, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى asked him, why you didn't bow down يا Satan? لماذا لم تسجد? Why? He said, I'm better than him. Why? خلقتني. Satan is saying, يا رب, يا الله, you created me. Satan affirms the creation to Allah. يثبت الخلق لله. وخلقته أي آدم. You created Adam. طيب, in order for Satan to live, أنظرني يا رب. You're the only one who can allow me to live. Anzirni. Oh. ده بالعكس ده ساتن أثبت صفة الله للعزة بعزتك. في مسلم الآن يقول لك لا إله إلا الله وينفي يعطل صفة العزة لله. يقول لك ما فيش حاجة اسمها عزة. Oh. Satan affirmed that. Oh. So what was his problem? In لا إله إلا الله in the compliance. He did not comply. How many Muslims are not complying? Knowledge, certainty, acceptance, compliance with truthfulness. You must be truthful about it. في تفسير قوله تعالى والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به يقول ابن عباس والذي جاء بلا إله إلا الله. Truthfulness in your heart. And this is, by the way, what distinguishes a believer from a hypocrite. الصدق, the truthfulness. اسمع. ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين. They say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله وتلاقيه في الصف الأول. In the first line. تلاقيه نو. وإذا قاموا إلى الصلاة قاموا كسالى. What is missing? الصدق. He's not truthful about it. إذا جاءك المنافقون قالوا نشهد إنك لرسول الله والله يعلم إنك لرسوله والله يشهد إن المنافقين لكاذبون. When the hypocrites come to you, يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell you, we bear witness, يا محمد, أنك رسول الله. And Allah knows that you are His messenger, and Allah bear witness that they are liars. نفاق يا إخوة, نفاق العقدي الكبير الأكبر. صدق, إخلاص, sincerity. You must be sincere in what you do. ألا لله الدين الخالص. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the sincere deen. The seventh and the last condition, the love. آخر شرط, the love, المحبة. ومن الناس من يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يحبونهم كحب الله والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. That you love Allah. You love that Allah to be worshipped. You love that Allah to be obeyed. You love Islam so much. You love, you're so excited about Islam. You love the deen of Allah to rise. You love it, you want to show it in earth. You show it in the way that you look, in the way that you dress. تمشي كده وتقول أنا مسلم أهو, أنا مسلم. Not your name is Muhammad. Oh, what is your name? Oh, my name is Mu. ليه يا مو؟ مش عايز يظهر الإسلام. Why يا مو؟ مش مبسوط بالإسلام. مكسوف من الإسلام. ما بيحبش الإسلام. Oh. محبة. ثلاث من كن فيه. And this is the top of the line here. Three attributes. If you have, you then have tasted the sweetness of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah has a sweetness in this dunya. One of them, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. That you love Allah and His Messenger more than you love anything else in the face of this earth. These are the teeth, brothers and sisters in Islam, which are needed for you to have La ilaha illallah. So that you can utter it at the bed of death, so that it can help you get to Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in closing, there is one man in this ummah. حديث في مستدرك الحاكم, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما, will be called in the day of resurrection. يُصَاحُ بِرَجُلٍ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي عَلَى رُؤُوسِ الْخَلَائِقِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. One man from this ummah. One person only. This hadith, ya ikhwa, is different to hadith al-Sab'ah, the seven who will be shaded under the throne. Under the Imam can come, the just Imam can come maybe 100,000. But see, this is one man from the ummah. وَهَذِي أَقْوَالَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. Look at this now. He will have sins recorded in 99 folders, books. 99 books. Here is the amazing piece. If you unfold that, if you, one of these rules, it will reach as far as his eyesight reaches. Sins. He will think he's to perish, he's doomed. Khalas. He's done. It's over. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, be present when your scale is set. احضر وزنك. He will say, Ya Rab, all these sins, what I'm going to do with it? إِنَّ لَكَ عِنْدَنَا بِطَاقَةٍ. First of all, by the way, Allah will ask him, were you wronged? Did the scribes write anything that he did not do? No, Ya Rab, I did everything. I did everything. He will say, there is a noot here. There is one noot. فَيَقُولْ يَا رَبْ. He will say, يَا رَبْ مَا تَفْعَلْ هَذِهِ الْبِطَاقَ أَمَامْ هَذِهِ السِّجِلَّةِ. What this note will do in the scale in front of all these books of sins. فَيَقُولْ إِنِّي لَا يُظْلَمُ عِنْدِي الْيَوْمَ أَحْدِ. سبحانه وتعالى. No one is wrong today. No one is wrong today. This note will be placed in the other pan of the scale and the 99 books in the other pan. Guess what? This note will outweigh the 99 books. You know what's written there? La ilaha illallah. This is a Muslim who understood some of the things or what I said, or more than what I said in the first half of the khutbah. He knew what La ilaha illallah is, but weak. Magdirshi. Striving, magdirshi. This is what matters at the end of the day, dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, Ya ibn Adam, O son of Adam, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطاي. You come to me in the day of resurrection with earth filled with sins, but with one condition, that you know that word, La ilaha illallah. La tushrik bi shay'an. Ataytuka bi qurabiha maghfirah. I will meet you, I will bring you earth filled of forgiveness. This is an invitation, brothers and sisters in Islam, and it's in a way a continuation of my last khutbah for you to learn La ilaha illallah. So it can help you at the bed of death. It can help you in the day of resurrection. It can help you to enter Jannah. And you can call people to it. Allahumma aghfir lana dunubana wa israfana fi amrina. Thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan wa arzuqna attiba'ah. Wa arina al-batila batilan wa arzuqna ajtinaabah. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.